Hello students, welcome back to the another section of data communication and computer network. Today's topic is token passing system. Before starting this system, we should learn about the basics of the network access methods. On the previous class, we will learn about the TDMA, that is time division multiple access. So a communication network access method like TDMA, FDMA, that is frequency division multiple access, and CDMA, that uses a continuous repeating of frames, that is also known as tokens, that is transmitted onto the network by the controlling computer. Basically, a communication is completely based on a transmitter and a receiver end. There are two subsequent terminals there. Whenever we can pass data or we can transfer data from one system to another system, that is in the form of packets. And every individual packet must having its own frame structure. In this case, the frame is also known as token. As you know that token is called the smallest individual elements in any programming language. Here token is nothing. It is a small particularly information which is related or which is normally bundled with a particular packet. When a terminal or computer wants to send a message, if it waits for an empty token, the particularly frame doesn't have any particular value or some message that it fills with the address of destination system and some or its entire message. It means whenever the subsequent sender machine or the computer or the terminal sends certain information or certain message to its destination node, it normally convert or the subsequent particularly message should be divided into several frames. If a particular token does not contain any information or any data, that is empty frame, so it fills the address of the destination system. It must having the header concept or the header concept of the destination node or the destination system for the entire message. Every node on the message basically constantly monitoring the passing tokens. Whenever a token is passed or a frame or a packet is passed from one system to another system, it should be monitored, and particularly the passing tokens to determine if it is a particular destination or source of the message, in which case it collects or grabs the message and reset the token start to empty. So whenever I send certain message a particularly person, if the message receives by the receiver section or the receiver end, the amount of information or amount of frame or amount of token are normally delivered on the destination node. After that, the token release or the token becomes empty. So first of all, you should know that, or we should learn about that, what you mean by token. A token is nothing, it is a small message that circulates among the stations of a computer network, providing permission to the station for transmission. So, as I say earlier, whenever a message passed from one particular node to another node, that is normally called the arbitrary length of messages, or arbitrary length is divided into small particularly packets, and every individual packet must having its own frame structure, and that particular frame is normally known as tokens. So A token is nothing. It is a small message that circulates among the stations. So station 1, station 2, station 3, station 4. There are several stations in a network. It can circulate the subsequent particularly small amount of message from one station to another station, providing permission to the station for transmission. So it must having the appropriate authentication consent or the permission consent to circulate or to pass or to transmit the subsequent particularly message from one system to another system or one station to another station. If a station has a frame to transmit, when it receives a token, it sends the frame and then passes the token to the next station. So your particularly token is normally the initiative for the data, or we can say the message. And in this case, the particularly station have a frame. If a particular, for example, if a station called A have a particular frame to transmit, which is when it receives a particular token, it sends the frame and then passes to that token to the next station. So station 1 can pass the token to the subsequent nearby station, that is say station 2. Otherwise, it simply passes that token to the next station. If the token normally contain any frame or you can say data, it can pass from one station to another station. If it does not contain any data, that is called empty token, it normally like passes to the next station as an empty token. So token passing uses a token or series of bits. A token or a message is normally converting into the zeros and ones, that is the bit form. And a particularly token passing uses a token or series of bits to grant a device permission to transmit over the network. So the token passing system is nothing, or the token passing is nothing. It is normally passes the token, or that is normally called the series of bits, to grant a particularly like device permission to transmit over the network. If the network permit or the network have any permission to pass the subsequent token or the message from one station to another station. Whichever device has the token can put data into the network. When it transmits, or when its transmission is complete, the device passes the token along to the next device to the subsequent particularly topology. So it must depend, or it must focus about the protocol of the subsequent particularly network. So whichever device, say station 1 can pass data station station 1 can pass the data to the station 3, the intermediate node in the ring topology, that is called station 2. So the station 1 can pass its particularly token to the station 2, and because it is in a circular form, or the particularly station 2 again recirculate or retransmit the subsequent token to the station 3, and so on. Station particular system rules in the protocol specialization or specification permission, how long a device may keep the token. It depends upon the subsequent particular station, how much amount or how much particularly, like how long the subsequent token may be kept inside a subsequent station, how long it transmit for, and how to generate a new token if there is particular, there is not on one circulating. So it depends, completely depend upon the stations, how much particularly time they can take to hold, to forward to the subsequent particular, forward the token to the next station. So what is actual token passing continue? In token passing scheme, the stations are connected logically to each other in form of ring. So as you know that the ring topology is there, it is in a circular mode of or circular form of transmission, and access of station is governed by the token. So just simple example, we are making in a queue. So every individual person in the queue having its own particular number through which we can act. So the first person having one, the second having two, and so on. So that's why the token passing scheme, the stations are connected logically to each other in form of ring, and particularly access the station is governed by the token. So the network can provide the subsequent particularly token to the stations through which they can act. A token is a special bit pattern, that is zeros and ones, or a small particularly message which particularly circulate from one station to the next station in the some predefining order. So depends upon, like, if you have a particularly if you have a queue. So normally you are standing in a queue. So the very first person having the priority of 1 and followed by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. So this is basically, it is called the predefining order of subsequent particularly token or the particularly bit patterns or the message which is provided by the subsequent particularly network. So a token is a special particularly bit. So a particular token is a special bit pattern or a small message which particularly circulate from one station to the next to a particularly predefining order. As I say this one, and the next point is in token particularly ring, as you know that ring topology and as well as post topology, there are different type of topologies there. So in token ring, that is related with the like ring topology, a token is passing from one station to another particularly station or the nearby stations in the particular ring, whereas in the case of token bus, each station uses the bus to send the token to the next station in some predefining order. So as you know that there are two different type of topologies, topological structure there. One thing is called ring, that is in a circular form or the ring form, or in a particularly like in the on the other side, a bus having a particular single master channel, and by the help of the subsequent medium or channel, all the interrelated or all the stations are interrelated or interconnected with each other. So it is making in a sequence in the case of particularly bus, and in the case of ring, it having a circular particularly implementation. It is by the it is unidirectional. Either it may be in clockwise mode or it may be in anti-clockwise mode, whichever is possible. So in both cases, that is ring and bus, particularly ring, token represents permission to send. So it must require the subsequent particular token to be sent from one particular station to another station. It depends upon the networking permission. If a station has a particularly frame queued for transmission, when it receives the token, it can send that frame before it passes to the token to the next station. So particularly if a particular station having any frame, that is you can say the data, so it is queue for transmission, it is making in a queue, because one after another data can be transmitted on the in the case of like TDM, as you know that TDMA is there. So if a station has a particularly frame to be queued, it is normally in a queue for transmission. When it receives the token, first of all it normally collect the token, as you know that that is normally called ticket, or you can say the permission particularly for to transmitting or grabbing the subsequent particularly frame. So it can send that particular frame before it passes the token. So first of all it should pass the token to the nearby particular station or normally to the next station, and after that the particularly frame should be passed to the next station. So if it has no queued frame, so it is not having any queued frame, it passes the token simply. So normally the subsequent station does not contain any frame or any message, so it simply passes the token to the next station. After sending a particularly frame, each station must wait for all n stations, that is the number of stations including the sender system also, that itself you know that, and to send that token to their neighbors or nearby, and the particularly other particularly n minus 1 station to send a particular frame. So the very first particular station should pass the token to the next station. So that's why it is basically called the n stations should follow the token concept, but the next station is normally called n minus 1 because the station does not contain any token. The token is normally originated from the previous station of the subsequent network. So it is a simple particularly diagram which shows that there are four particularly stations there, like station 1, station 2, station 3 and station 4. It is in a particularly clockwise mode, and subsequently station 1, if station 1 creates the token, it can pass the token to the nearby, that is station 2, and followed by station 2 can pass the subsequent particularly token to the next station, that is 3, and 3 followed by 4, and 4 again reset or retransmit the token to the station 1. So this is basically called the token passing system from one station to another station, because in a network every individual particular station having a particular token which can circulate throughout the or entire particular throughout the network. So next is normally called the priority and non-priority system. So first of all, non-priority concept use it. So token passing is another particularly widely used widely used for implementing both peer-to-peer and as well as non-priority and as well as the priority system. As you know that priority system is nothing, it depends upon a subsequent priority. So network can provide the subsequent priority or subsequent particularly token priority to the subsequent particular station. So for example, if a particular network having four stations, if all the four stations having the equal priority, that is basically called non-priority system. If the station one can more privileges than station 2, 3 or 4, so the priority should be granted or should be provided to the station 1. It can actually pass the token or it can actually produce the token. So that this technique particularly is found in many local area network connections. So some of the particular token passing systems are implemented with horizontal bus topology. As you know that bus topology is based on a single particularly master cable, or you can say single master channel, and particularly others are with the ring topology. So in general, token passing system widely implemented with ring and as well as particularly bus topology. So this is basically called the diagram for free token and as well as the busy token. It's particularly in this particular diagram, there are two subsequent diagrams there, one for free token, another for busy token. And the free token having particularly A, B, C, D, E, there are five particularly stations there. It is the particularly token normally passes from station A to station B, followed by C, D, E, and again it comes to the part of A. So it is normally called in an anti-clockwise mode. So this particularly station A normally creates the token, and the token should be passed to the subsequent particularly station B. That's why it is here in this case, that is U1, U2, U3, like user 1, user 2, user 3, like that user 5. So this particular token does not contain any data. That's why this type of diagram is normally related with the free token particularly system or the free token free token particularly passing system. On the other side, this particularly system or this particularly diagram says that it is a busy token. As per this particular diagram, there are two subsequent particularly like options there, like one thing is called data, another is called the frame, and one thing is called token, another thing is called data. If a particular token normally followed by the data, it is called the busy token. So first of all, some token passing systems are implemented as I say earlier in the bus topology and as well as the ring topology. So that this particularly diagram shows that the stations are connected in a particularly concentric particularly ring, that is a circular ring, through a particular ring interface unit that is called RIU. This is called RIU. It is a ring particularly interface unit, and each particularly RIU is responsible for monitoring or inquiry the data passing through it, as well as also for particularly regenerating the transmission and as well as passing to the next station. So the main particularly like work or the job of the RIU, that is ring interface like unit, having monitoring system over the subsequent token and as well as the transmission and as well as passing the subsequent token to the nearby or to the next station. So in this particular case, the address in the particularly header of the transmission indicates that the data indicates that data are particularly destined or targeting for a particular station. The RIU copies the data and as well as passes the information to the user DTE, that is the terminal. So basically the RIU or the particularly like ring interface unit, normally monitoring whole things and as well as copy the subsequent particular data from and as well as passes the subsequent information to the next particular station, that is next particular DD which is attached to it. So if the ring is idle, so if the subsequent particular ring does not have any particular data communication or particular transmission of data, so particularly a free token is passed around the subsequent ring form and particularly it can pass to node to node. So in the first particular diagram, this is called free token. The token does not contain any particular data, so the subsequent token can pass under the supervision of RIU from station 1 or station A to station B or B to C, C to D and as well as D to E. Again it returns to the E to A. So it is in a particularly like a circular form. So a free token indicates that the ring is free. So that's why it is basically called the ring particularly free token. That's why it is normally in an idle mode. And any station that particularly has data to transmit can use the particular token to transmit the data. So if a particular station having its own frame to transmit it to the nearby or subsequent particular station, it is completely like the token is free. So the station can be easily pass its frame or pass its data from one station to another station. The control of the ring is token based sequentially like from node to node in the subsequent state. It is in a pairing mode form, one to one, that is particular node to node. It can particularly like sequentially it can pass the subsequent particular token in a ring particularly manner. So this technique is called implicit implicit token system, because any station is allowed to transmit data when it resides or particularly a free token. So it is normally called the non-priority system. So that's why there is no priority can be given to the subsequent station. So anyone can particularly transmit or anyone can join its particularly frame to the subsequent token, which is passed in a circular form. So on the other side, the busy token also having that thing. So if the subsequent particularly frame, because like the station A having in this case having some data, so it can pass the subsequent data along with the subsequent token to the next particularly like station. So the next one is called the token passing priority. The token is used in a particular ring topology to continue use of the ring by a particularly free or particularly busy indication. Either it may be a free token concept or it may be a busy particular token concept. So it is basically the token particularly which is passed or which is used on a particular ring topology to continue use of the ring. So it is in a circular form by a particularly free or busy particular indication. So if a particularly station can pass its particularly frame to a subsequent station, so it is in a busy mode, because the transaction or the transmission between station A to station B normally indicates that it is busy. Otherwise, if a free token is passed from one station to another station, it is normally indicated as free. So a busy token is one which indicates that the station has been seized by one the particular system in the network. As I say earlier, if a subsequent particular token that is normally related with busy that having data, so it is normally called freeze or seized by the subsequent particular station in the subsequent network. When a particular free token reaches its destination or at a particular station, the station wants to use that, it puts the data that token and as well as send it to the next station. As I see earlier, if a particular token is free from station 1 to station 2, so the first of all, the particular token normally passes to the next station. So the station wants to use that particularly like and put that data, that token and send to the next station. So if a particularly token does not contain any data in the station 1, So your station particular to having certain frame, so it can add or it can actually connect to the subsequent particular token to passing the subsequent frame to the nearby stations. So if station attached to the token passing priority system, network has a priority previously assigned to it. As I say particularly earlier, non-priority system is called predefined and it is also predefined, but non-priority system does not particularly provide any priority. All the subsequent stations have equal priority. But in this case of token passing priority system, each system which is attached to the subsequent token, or you can say the network, is having its own particularly priority which is assigned by the subsequent system or assigned by the subsequent network. Token passing priority is to give each station an opportunity to reserve the use of the ring for the next transmission around the ring. So priority, obviously, if a certain station having highest priority and station certain stations having like average priority or minimum priority, so the priority should be like focused on the highest priority tokens or highest priority stations. In the system, each token having a reservation field which holds a particularly number of which holds a number. So basically, every individual system having its own token, and the token normally having a reservation field, and the reservation field holds a particularly token, or you can say a number. So the subsequent particularly like number which is based on, so the reservation field which holds the subsequent number, when a system wants to use the token, it arises the reservation field number by its own priority number, and as well as then stores the reservation field value in a temporary storage particular place. So as you know that like the token the ring topology having store and forward method. So in this case, the token passing system also based on the store and forward method, because there is no direct particularly link to the other stations. It normally connect to the nearby stations. So that's why the store and forward, every individual token having its own particularly reservation field which holds the number, because a priority is completely based on a number. So that's why if the particularly if the next particularly like station passes, that is when the token comes again to the system by making one cycle, so there are five subsequent particularly there are subsequently in the network there are five particular station there. If a token can pass from station A to B, then B to C, C to D and D to E, then again the particular token is like transmit or can pass from E to A. So it is normally make a particular cycle. So the particular it can, whenever the particular cycle is completed, a cycle around the particular ring, the station uses the token to transfer the data to any station it wants itself. So basically it releases the token by changing the reservation field number, whatever it was started at the temporary storage field. So the first time the reservation field having one number, if a particularly token can circulate or complete its cycle, then again the reservation field like provide another particularly number to the subsequent state. So thank you.